Kitsilano Theater Company's web series, What's Your Story? I'm Brendan Sangster, one of the drama teachers here at Kitsilano Secondary School. Thank you so much for joining us today, and again, for another amazing season of What's Your Story? Last year, we asked the teachers of Kitsilano why they became teachers, and what their individual paths were that brought them to work here at Kitsilano. Now in season two, we're asking our guests to get even deeper and more vulnerable by allowing our own Kitsilano students to recreate stories from their past high school experiences. Last year, we bridged the gap between student to teacher. This year, students will be taking on the retelling. These are stories you won't want to miss. So once again, we ask the question, what's your story? My guest today is one of my favorite people in our school. From the digital world, teaching graphic arts, and the master of memories, immortalizing our school experiences in our yearbook, please join me in welcoming Mr.Mehl. Applause in the audience. Mr.Mehl, welcome to our little studio. May I cross across here and join you?
Sure.
Thank you for joining us. I am so excited about this year because we get to now, you know, just hear a completely different version of who we are as teachers, and I think show students, you know, how similar we really are, and then for them to embody us will be a really exciting, you know, exciting experience.
Sure.
So yeah, tell me, what was, let's just jump right into it. What was high school like for you, and what's the story that you thought of right away?
Well, my high school was a very different type of high school. It was a bit of a leftover from the 70s.
Okay.
So maybe a hippie era. Attendance was optional. But don't ever ask a teacher, what did I miss yesterday? Because you'd just be laughed at. So we didn't have to go to class. We could write our own notes. Science classes were self-paced units that we did ourselves at our own speed. So you could finish a class early, finish a class, you know, on your lunch. A lot of selections. We had to build our own timetables. So if you wanted to change classes with a student, you had to find the people you wanted to trade with.
Right. Okay.
So sometimes it'd be a four-way split. You'd have to find four people, and then the four of you would go see the counselor. And then we'd move all the classes around. And
do you have one of those teachers that's super memorable, especially this time period you're speaking about? Was there like a turn of phrase or like a certain person just jumps out as like a character to you?
Well, one story that I thought of, one of the very strong characters in the school, while the school didn't have a lot of discipline in that sense, there was the deal was that if you did fail at the school, you were welcome to transfer to the other high school across town that had hall monitors and all this other kind of stuff. So the person who was the gatekeeper was Mr. Henry.
Okay.
And Mr. Henry was the vice principal in charge of discipline. And his thing was he signed all of his notes with a green pen.
Okay.
So if there was a green memo, that the only thing we had to attend every day was homeroom.
Right.
So we'd go to homeroom. It was like a 15, 20 minute thing, and we'd have key announcements and check in stuff. So if there was a green memo in the pile that our homeroom teacher had, that was a green, you knew somebody had done something and was in trouble. So this green memo was always the thing. Was Mr. Henry wrote in green. So I came to the school new in grade 10, and I was living with another family, and sort of kept below the radar in grade 10, sort of getting my feel around the school. In grade 11, I moved back home with my parents, and I was actually moved out of district for the school, so I was actually like an illegal alien in the school.
Okay.
And Mr. Henry's deal was, he knew there was a few of us who were in that situation, and his deal was, as long as you didn't get into trouble, he would sort of, you know, put a blind eye to it and sort of let us stay, basically.
Okay, but Mr. Mehl, I'm still having trouble imagining exactly who you were in high school, because you're saying you're an illegal alien.
Yes.
Are you on the hippie side? Are you on the rebel side? Who is the character? Who were you at this time? Were you the artsy person you are today, or were you this military?
Well, I used to, you know, other students used to say, you're weird, and I'd say thank you.
Uh-huh, okay.
So that would maybe put it a little bit into context. So I, you know, buy my clothes at the Army Surplus store.
Army Surplus.
And,
yeah. Long hair, short hair, afro.
I grew.
Okay.
And then I think by the end of grade 12, I cut it all off and had a mohawk for a few days to collect on some bets. And then, Then anyway, So the story with Mr. Henry was that in the summer after grade 10, I worked at a stationery store, Grand & Toy, and in walked Mr. Henry.
Grand & Toy.
Yeah, Grand & Toy.
For all those young people out there, yeah. It doesn't exist anymore.
It does.
It does?
They still do exist. Yeah, yeah. They have a warehouse down in Burnaby. Anyway, but Mr. Henry walks in and he says, I need a refill for my green pen.
Okay.
Uh oh. Okay. No. So like.
Okay, Mr. Henry, what is he like?
So Mr. Henry is.
You're in the Mohawk, and he's.
He's he's fun to suit. He's, you know, he's a stocky, you know, relatively, you know, tough kind of personality. He had to deal with all those hooligans at the school. So he comes in anyway. His pen is a special order thing. I hooked him up with the refills for his green pen. He was happy. That was the end of the summer. I didn't think about it anymore. Halfway through grade 11,
yeah.
I and some friends, we had started a bunch of fake clubs.
Okay.
Like the chess club and math club, which didn't actually exist, but it was meant for accessing student council funds, and that went towards pizzas. But
right.
Anyway, so we would put announcements in for these clubs, and we would put bulletin things in to make them seem more legit, so that these actually existed, but they were just sort of in jokes that we talked about.
I can see where you're going here.
So
chess club, math club, but really you're all sneakily these artsy rebels having pizza.
Yeah,
I see it.
Yeah, so that was sort of that was it. So, but then halfway through the year, PA announcement, could re-enactment please come to the office and see Mr. Henry? I'm going, oh. I think maybe just got busted. And my friends who are running these clubs with me, they're looking at me like, what's going on? Because we're not in class. We're in a special room playing cards. That's what we would be doing. So I go, okay, so walking up to the office, my proverbial tail between my legs,
right.
Going, okay, am I busted? Am I getting big trouble? Am I going to lose the privilege of going to the school? Like, how much trouble am I in here? So I was rather nervous. So I'm, you know, put on my, you know, what did I do? I have no idea what's going on.
Just
imagine, you know, resting
it's like the
face.
Shining. It's like the
and
shining
I'm,
hallway.
Yeah, exactly. I'm standing in front of the office going, okay, all right, so how do I play this? So I'm taking this deep breath. I'm like, okay, what's going to happen? What's going to happen? But let's not be nervous. So the door opens. I get into Mr. Henry. I'm standing in front of his desk going, okay, what's going to happen now? He looks at me and goes, so Reiner, I'm running out of pens. Can you get me some more refills for my pens? I'm like, well, sure, I'll take care of that.
Yes.
Oh thank
goodness.
You. So I'd see you, Mr. Henry, and take care. So I walked back out of the office and I'm like, whoo, got away with that one. Walk down and get my friends like, what happened?
Wow.
Like, yeah, he just needs more refills for his pens. I'm good.
Safe.
So like,
safe for another
safe,
day.
Safe on that one. So yes, that was one of the sort of highlight stories. And then, you know, next year we amped it up and we got a person who was no longer in the school elected as student council president. that's a whole other story. So.
Well, yeah. Mr. Mehl, I mean, you're giving me a lot of ideas. If I was still in high school, I hope that our students are just as creative as you are, because really, I just see, you know, some clever tactics here and thinking outside the box.
Yeah.
Isn't that what we need in this
world?
Oh,
yeah, yeah. That's why I'm always impressed with my students when they can be creative with what they're doing. So.
I love that. Yeah. I mean, these websites are quite short, but I do want to bring back a tradition we asked from last year, and maybe it goes to, I want to ask you, what was the song of your experience? What's the song that you most associate with being in high school?
Song that I experienced, I think for me, a big part of high school is the soundtrack to Purple Rain.
Purple Rain. There
yeah.
you go, guys.
Yeah.
Tells me everything I need to know.
So, yeah.
Well, thank you, Mr. Mehl, for being our first guest of What's Your Story Season 2. I know I can't wait to see what this life was like and your story recreated.